I've been a member of the department since 1997. I was originally a volunteer and then later became a full-time staff member. Amy and I were married coming up on 6 years ago. She used to volunteer here, and then we have a little three-year-old boy named Jackson. He watches everything we do here, and he kind of emulates it, and he runs his own little calls in our basement with his fire trucks.
My fire service career actually started. I was just turned 16 years old, and I was on my way to a Boy Scout meeting, actually. I was involved in a severe car accident. The paramedics took care of me. I went down to the firehouse to thank them. And then one of the people came out of the back and said, "Have you ever thought about being a junior firefighter?" Within a year and a half, I decided that this is what I wanted to make a career. The Eureka Fire Protection District covers 82 square miles in St. Louis and Jefferson counties.
Very family-centric area for people. So it's a fun place to work because our fire department, our fire district is a part of that.
The fire service over the last 40 years has really evolved into an emergency hazard program.
We do firefighting, we do hazmat, so if there's a chemical spill or an incident involving a chemical, we do rescue. And then a large percentage, about 70% of all the calls we go on are EMS calls, emergency medical service. We could be eating, we could be taking a shower, we could be asleep, we could be in training, and our goal is to get out the door in 1 minute.
Fire grows rapidly, and if we can get there quicker and extinguish that fire when it's smaller, that's going to save not only property, but more importantly, lives of somebody who may be trapped inside that building.
So everybody has to work together for the best outcome. But in doing that, you become close. And, you know, you worry about each other, you care about each other, you care about each other's families.
And there is a brotherhood and a sisterhood that goes out from that base.
Just like, you know, you have this tightness and you have this love and all this for your family at home, you have the same thing for the people that you work with here.
Anytime they're around a fire, obviously the danger is they could be burned, they could be hurt, something could fall on them. But the other danger is in the smoke, in the products of combustion. There is all kinds of carcinogens that are produced that come out in the event of a fire.
You know, after a firefighter's inside a building, they come out, we have them wipe their face, wipe their neck down, wipe their hands off. They have two sets of gear, so they'll put their other set of gear, make it ready. The gear they wore will be washed. We don't want them to wash their clothes at home with their kids' clothes, their family's clothes, because we know those risks.
And those are part of the policies that we do, but we also have policies that we do baseline medical screening of our personnel.
We were presented with an opportunity to do some additional testing.
We did the testing. We had 37 of our people go through the testing. Out of those 37 people that went through that testing, we had 4 come back that markers hit that said there's a problem.
My blood work came back that said I need to get checked. And I went to our local cancer center and was found to have prostate cancer.
One of them, the lung cancer test, came back that says I have lung cancer. When you hear the word cancer, it's devastating. It scares the hell out of you. What's going to happen to my children? What's going to happen to my grandkids? And so you spend a lot of time thinking. Early detection of lung cancer, you got a 92% survival rate. That's what I live off of.
Because of that early detection, there's a 99% survivability rate. And because it was caught early, when you think about prostate cancer, if you have to take radical surgery, if you have to do radiation, that would eliminate our chance to have another kid. We still have that chance, and that's, you know, we wanna grow our family.
Sure, there's that thought in the back of that person's head, oh my gosh, I got cancer. But to realize that by finding it early, the chances of survival are so much greater.
As a fire department, we're here to protect the community when they have a problem, right? As a fire department itself, though, we have to protect our members.
Firefighters are dying. Firefighters are having cancer. And we can help prevent a lot of that.
We have firefighters that, you know, work 25, 30 years. We should be committed that they can live 25 or 30 years beyond their retirement.
So we use the term, everybody goes home. At the end of every shift, everybody goes home. I want everybody to work a long career here, get to retire, and then have a long, healthy retirement.
Every day we go out there to save people's lives, we need to make sure that we save our own lives too.